Hey guys, it's your boy Roberts, and yes, I'm doing this again. This is my January the transfer target for Liverpool in 2015's January window, which is so close now, which is so weird because it feels like the summer window just fucking closed. What the hell? Where did the year go? Oh, guys, where did the fucking year go? Sorry about that. I did this around this time last year, or maybe I think it was actually at the start of January I did this last year, and it has almost 5,000 views. So right now I just want to thank you guys for that was amazing. Some of those didn't come to pass. I actually don't remember who I predicted would join us in that window. I just know most of them didn't. But yeah, I'm here to do this again. Hopefully I'll be more right this time. You can see I'm in my Liverpool colors because of Well, by the time you're watching this, it's Sunday, and it is the day of the Liverpool-Manchester United match at Old Trafford. The match that will determine whether Brendan Rodgers will be leading us into the January transfer window or not, because if we lose, he will most likely be sacked. Especially after we went out of the Champions League. Which was all his fault. And if anyone disagrees with that, you're obviously not a Liverpool fan. There you go. Let's get into the players. First name that's being mentioned a lot, especially over the past couple of weeks, past couple of months, it's pretty much been a big rumor ever since maybe mid-November. And that is Petr Cech, Mega Man himself, with his Mega Man helmet, Chelsea's Petr Cech. Now, a lot of people will be like, why would Petr Cech leave Chelsea and join Liverpool? One, he's not playing at Chelsea. Courtois plays all the freaking time unless he's injured. And for you wondering, why would Chelsea sell one of their best players to Liverpool? Where did we get Daniel Sturridge from? Oh yeah, that's right. We got him from Chelsea. Because he was being underused. Why not the same with freaking Cech? It's the same deal. Well, pretty much. It's the same. Cech has the same problem. He's not being used. He'd be used at Liverpool because Mignolet is shit. He doesn't know how to save. He is not a goalkeeper. Whoever told Mignolet when he was young, when he was growing up, training to be a footballer, that he should be a goalkeeper, yeah, that person should kill himself because he has no idea what a goalkeeper does. Mignolet is not a goalkeeper. I would prefer to have Reyna in goal at this point. And I hate Reyna. Every Tom, Dick, and Harry knows I hate Reyna. So that's how bad Mignolet is. Another name that was linked a lot was Victor Valdez, who's a free agent. That kind of died down. There was talks of him going to Manchester United, but I can't see it. I can only see him joining a team if he's going to play all the time. And I don't know. It'd be 50-50 with him and De Gea because Louis van Gaal seems to be a big fan of De Gea. De Gea, De Gea, whatever it is. It's something. It's one of them. And, well,
They moist stuff with the hand. Well, that didn't turn out well, so we'll see how it works out for Louis Van Gaal. Right now, it's working well. Mané are actually on a good run. So, maybe Van Gaal is not looking for a new goalkeeper. If he's smart, which I see him as being, he will get some defenders, because that's where Manchester United lack. I diverse. We're talking about Liverpool. Hey, Manchester United fans, you can feel free to leave in the comment section who your club is targeting. And I'm hoping, if you do, I will see defender names. Yes. Because that's what you need. You have a supreme, you have a brilliant strike force, you have a great midfield, you have a beastly midfield. Your defense is the only thing lacking. Simple. I'm a Liverpool fan and I know what you guys need. I know what Man United need. Because I have the knowledge. Hitch, unlike Brendan Rodgers. Again, I diverse. I'm getting off topic. I do that a lot. Oh yeah. Victor Valdez. I don't see him joining a club unless he's going to be playing every single game. Which I don't think he will at Manchester United. So, if he doesn't join Liverpool, a Premier League club he might join is someone who needs a top-class goalkeeper and is playing alright. Maybe he could join someone like a Southampton or a Newcastle or a West Ham and provide first team competition for their current goalkeepers. Because obviously he'd be the better goalkeeper and straight away, whereas he might not be at a team like Manchester United. Another team who he could go to is Arsenal, if Arsenal aren't too, because Chesney's not been playing his best football this season. He's been playing better than Man United, but he's not been having his best season in an Arsenal shirt. Granted, he was injured recently, I think, because I think he played against, in the game against Stoke. I think it was somebody else, wasn't it? It was the Irish guy, wasn't it? That's awkward. Again, I really gotta stop doing that. Next name that's being linked a lot is Martin Montoya at the Barcelona right back. There's a lot of rumors that Juventus will be signing Glenn Johnson. Why that is, I don't understand. He has scored one goal, one important goal. Oh, the rest of the season he's been shit. Since he scored that goal, he's been shit. In the game, he scored the goal. He was shit. That was the only good thing he has done all season. All that and the time he spent injured. Yeah, that was pretty good for us. And another right back name is, I can't think of it off the top of my head. I'm trying. Crap. I will get back to that. Other names being linked other names that could possibly come into the team. I'm going to talk about Ings first, and now I'll talk about the players who might be leaving. So, yeah, there's that. There's rumors about Karim Benzema, but that was only, like, once, and that was directly after the summer window ended. I think the rumor now is Jackson Martinez, because I've heard his name mentioned a lot. So, you never know. Maybe if we can do a deal with Porto. I mean, why not? Martinez is an amazing player. I don't get the chance to see him a lot because I never watched the Portuguese league, unfortunately. And from FIFA, I know he is an amazing player, and anyone who plays FIFA will know he is an amazing player. A lot of goalkeeper names are being mentioned, obviously, because we need a new goalkeeper, because Mignolet is just not good enough. In no way is he good enough. And strikers, because we need someone to partner Daniel Sturridge when he does actually come back, if Brendan Rodgers will stop trying to force him back before he is 100%. Probably not. That's a very pissed. Not saying that, just so you know. Anyway, but yeah, other names being mentioned are Winston Reid, Javier Hernandez, and Fernando Torres are coming up for some reason. Hernandez, not a fucking chance. That's not gonna happen. A few days ago, I saw us being linked with freaking Kevin Morales. Yes, of Everton. Who the hell came up with that rumor? What idiot thought? Yeah, Morales. I'm not freaking Morales. One, we don't need wingers. Because we have two brilliant wingers. If only we'd actually play them both at the same fucking time. Rodgers, hello, Coutinho, freaking play him! Torres, I haven't been watching the Serie A, so I don't know if he's playing well at Milan. But to be honest, he can't play much worse than Barry. Yo, Missitelli. Torres has more goals in a Chelsea shirt than Balotelli does for Liverpool. That's sad. That's a sad stat right there, ladies and gentlemen. You know you're bad if you've performed worse than Torres did at Chelsea or and Andy Carroll did at Liverpool. Those stats do not say good things about Mario Balotelli. There's nothing on the planet that says a good thing about him, but I digress again. I'm getting off topic. But yeah, those really defenders and a striker and a goalkeeper are the main things. Obviously, we don't really need midfielders unless someone leaves. And that's where we get into the possible departings. Still rumours about Fabio Borini going back to Sunderland, this time on a permanent basis. Obviously, Liverpool accepted a bid from Sunderland in summer. The bid was there, it was on the table, and Borini said, no, I want to stay at Liverpool and I want to fight for my spot. Little did he realise that Brendan Rodgers would completely forget about him and now thinks that he is still out on loan. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is why Borini never seems to play. Because Rodgers doesn't actually think he got Borini back. He must think that Sunderland still have him on loan. Someone from Sunderland needs to ring up Brendan Rodgers and say, yeah, you know, Borini, we gave him back to you. No, we did. Of course we did. Why else would we be bidding for him if he is still your player? How stupid are you? I can't imagine someone from Sunlight. I don't know who's in charge of Sunlight right now. I don't think it's now Quinn anymore. Well, I can't imagine anyone at Sunlight doing that, but that's what I do. Rumors linking Glenn Johnson with both AC Milan, Juventus, and Roma. Again, I don't understand. Yes, he's experienced, but his experience of this season, he's been shit.
Okay.
Obviously, there's the talk that Steven Gerrard might leave Liverpool and go to America like David Beckham did a few years ago. He's been linked with LA Galaxy, Robert Keane's team, and New York Red Bulls, the team that Thierry Henry has just actually left. He might be actually coming back to the Premier League. Keep an eye on that. Jesus Fernandez is being linked with AC Milan again. For those of you who are like, who the hell was that? That is Suso. That's his full name. We just call him Suso. Because apparently, Jesus Fernandez is too long. Actually, that's not the reason. It's just he prefers to be called that. I don't know where that name came from, but I'm sure he would explain it to me. If I ever got the chance to meet him. Now, he's not... Now, I'm going to talk about someone who isn't linked with a move. From what I've seen, I haven't heard any rumors. But I am really, really worried about this man. Philippe Coutinho. I mean, Brendan Rodgers never seems to fucking play him. Because he can't get it into his head that if he plays Coutinho, we might actually play good. I mean, if Coutinho came on and he changed the game against Basel, if Coutinho starts that match, we'd still be in the Champions League, and Brendan Rodgers would not be. He facing possible be, the possibility of being sacked if he loses to Manchester United today. But he is an idiot, and he's not playing one of our better players. I mean, for fuck's sake, you signed him for a reason. What was the fucking point if you're not going to play him? It hurts my brain thinking about this, and I'm really worried that if a bid comes in for Coutinho, he might say, you know what, you're not playing me, here's a transfer request, I don't want to stay here. He might actually do that. No, you don't know. Players want to play. That's kind of their job. They're professionals, they want to play. That's how they earn their living. Coutinho wants to play in our first team, and he is good enough. But Brendan Rodgers does not apparently think he is good enough. I don't know what the hell is wrong with Rodgers. Coutinho was good last year. He was good enough last year because you were freaking playing him. But now, no, freaking. Yes. Is it because he didn't get picked for Brazil? Lucas didn't get picked for Brazil, and you playing him? And he's playing well, mind you. So why are you leaving Coutinho out? Again, I'm getting off topic. I really ought to stop doing that. But yeah. Before any comments say, what about Raheem? Raheem is going to sign a new contract. He is not going to Real Madrid. He's having a bad season. Why would Real Madrid sign someone who is having a bad season?
He had a good first couple of games, but his form has dropped. I'm very capable of admitting Raheem's form has dropped. We're depending on him too much. What needs to happen is Rodgers needs to get us, Coutinho and Raheem, to practice their shooting, because Raheem squandered a very good chance. If he shoots that chance, he scores and we go through again. He had low confidence. He didn't. I mean, if that was near the start of the season when he was scoring, when he scored his 3 goals, he would have shot that and he would have scored. But having all the pressure of being pretty much a lone striker, because Ricky Lambert had a good run of games, gets taken off after half time, replaced by Lars Markovic, who gets sent off. Again, I'm getting off topic. I really gotta stop doing that. But I can't see Real Madrid signing Raheem. When his form is down. Last season or early in the season, maybe. But not right now. They're not going to sign him right now. And he's only stalling on that new contract because the wages are too low. And I agree. If he wants more money, give it to him. Why would you not give him more money? He's one of our best players. He's just having a bit of bad form. Simple as that, really. He will hit his stride again as soon as there's a bit less pressure on him. And that will come when Daniel Sturridge is back. Or when we've signed a new striker. So, what do you think of my predictions for Liverpool's transfer targets? Let me know if you're a Liverpool fan. Let me know in the comment section below who you'd like to see us sign in the January transfer window, and what you think of the predictions I have made. And if you're a fan of any other team, let me know what your club might be doing in the January transfer window, because I'd like to know. And if you like to see me do videos on other clubs, I am very open to doing those if you guys will watch them. So let me know in the comment section below if you'd like to see me talk about your team. I'm not going to wear their jersey because I'm a freaking Liverpool fan. But there you go. If you want me to talk about your team, leave it in the comment section below. And I'll consider doing it. So, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you all next time. Don't forget to leave a comment down below about what I talked about. Peace.